Good day, peoples. I welcome you back again to JCBest School Mathematics class. This class is for Basic 5 and Basic 6. I hope you had a nice weekend and I hope you're staying safe. So our topic for this week is we are going to be looking at what? At long division of what? Of numbers. Repeat after me. Long division of what? Of numbers. And our specific objective for this class is by the end of the lesson, you should be able to what? State the rules of what? Of long division. There are rules that we're going to learn that we need to what? Guide us in what? In achieving our objective. And another objective is we're going to divide what? Two-digit numbers. Meaning throughout this class, we're going to be dealing with what? Two-digit number. That means two-digit of the dividend and what? And one-digit of the divisor. So I'm going to show you what I mean by that. So let's start. Okay, in dividing whole numbers, there are terms that we need to know. What and what are you doing? Now here, I want to divide what? 64 by 2. And my answer is what? 32. So what is this 2? What is 64 and what is 32? Remember we did this last time when we did directed numbers, division of directed numbers. So you can just tell me what this 2 is, what this 64 is, and what this 32 is. You will hear my answer next. Okay, if you said the correct answer, give yourself a big clap. The 2 here is what is the divisor. 64 is the dividend and 32, which is our answer, is called what? The quotient. So when you want to divide 64 by 2, your answer is called what? Quotient. Okay, now this divisor tells us what we are dividing and the dividend tells us how many times we're going to what? Divide it, and we'll get what? 32. You get that? So let's start. So that is when you're asked to what? Find the quotient of what? Of 30, of 64 by 2. So don't tell me what is quotient, right? Quotient is just the answer that you will get when you want, when you are done dividing what? Your numbers. Okay, there are rules that will help us in what? In doing long division, and they are members of our family. We have to memorize it using what? Members of our family. So yeah, we have daddy, we have mommy, we have our sister, we have our brother, and we have our pet. Let's say our pet is Coco, which is cat, and our dog is what? Is Rover. So the members of our family, they are going to what? Guide us in what? In long division. Now let's give them a name. So daddy will be called what? Divide. Mommy will be called what? Multiply. Our sister will call her subtract. Our brother will be bring down. The pet, which is dog, Rover, will be called what? Reminder or repeat. It's just like you're repeating what? The step in your long division, okay? So we call it what? Repeat or reminder. And our cat, which is Coco, will be our check. So members of our family will help us in what? In achieving long division of numbers. Again, daddy is the divide, mommy is multiply, sister is subtract, brother is bring down, Rover is reminder or repeat, and Coco is what? Is check, meaning that we will check if our answer is what? Is correct. Okay, I know you are so excited to see how we're going to do this. So let's move on. Let's say we want to divide what? 64 by 2, just like in the introduction I showed you, right? Of course you already know what you have, 32, but how do you have 32? Now our daddy is going to help us. That's the first step, okay, in long division, which is what? Our divide. So let's see the step will follow. So daddy said divide 2 into the first number of what? Of the dividend. Okay, so the dividend is what you're dividing. So we'll divide 2 into the first number of what? Of the dividend. And remember, what we are dividing is just what? Two digit what? Numbers. Okay, so 64 is what? Is two digit what? Number. And next thing, you have to think of how many 2s will fit into what? Into 6. How many 2s will fit into 6? Now, let's think about it. How many 2 will fit into 6? Is what? 3, 2, okay? So if we divide 2 into 6, will give us what? 3. Alright, so that's perfect. So what we'll do, divide say which is daddy, say we should write that number directly above the number you divided into. So meaning that the number we divided into is what is 6, okay, just 6, which is just the first number, and the 2 goes into 6 how many times? 3 times, okay, follow my cursor, 3 times. So meaning that it said we should write that number directly above the number you divided into. So the number we divided into is what? It's 6. So we're going to write the number, which is 3, directly above it. Let's see. Okay, we've done that. So let's move to the next one, which is mommy. Mommy is what? Is multiply. Okay, so mommy said multiply the divisor. Remember, our divisor is what? Is 2 here. Divisor by the first number of what? Of the quotient. This is the first number of the quotient which we got from daddy. So we multiply what? 2 by 3, which gives us what? 6. Okay, now we have to write the answer directly under what? 6 of the number you just divided into. So we are writing it what? 6. So meaning that here 2 times 3 is 6. So we write the number under what? Under 6 here. Okay, under the number we just divided what? Into. I hope this is fine for now. Okay, let's continue. So we are done with daddy, we are done with mommy. So next one is what? Is sister. Okay, sister is what? Subtraction. So let's see what sister said. Sister said we should draw a line under what? 6. So this is my line, this red line you see here is my line, and she also said we should write what? The subtraction sign next to 6. So we have what? Our subtraction sign here. I hope you're following me. Now sister also say subtract 6 from 6. Okay, so meaning that 6 from 6 we're going to what? Subtract it, and we'll write our answer directly below what? 6. So guess where our answer will be? It will be at this point. So 6 minus 6 will give us what? 0. So we are done with what? With sister, which is what? Subtraction. So the next one is what? Is our brother. Let's see what our brother will say. Our brother is what? Is bring down. Okay, so far we've gotten just one number of what? Of the quotient, but we are not done with the what? With the long division. Okay, so this brother say go to the next number in the dividend. So the next dividend is what? Is 4, meaning that we are having just 2 numbers, right? So we are done with 6. So the next number we are going to look at is what? Is 4. Go to the next number in the dividend, which is 4, to the right of what? Of 6. Okay, we are there now. This is my cursor here. We are there. We are in the next number, which is 4. So let's see what brother is also saying. He said draw an arrow under what? Under 4. Okay, we've drawn an arrow under 4. Now bring the 4 down next to the 0. Okay, let's see. You see, it's just like we are still subtracting. Remember, we already have 0 here. That is 6 minus 6 already give us 0. So brother say bring down. We are bringing down, right? After we've done with sister, which is subtraction, now we are what? Bringing down, meaning that we are bringing down what? 4. Okay, we are bringing down 4. It's just like there's nothing here, so we assume here is 0, right? So it's just like 4 minus 0, which gives us what? 4. Okay, so let's see what the Rover said. Okay, not Rover. Okay, Rover, yeah. So Rover is what? Is repeat, meaning that we are doing this over again. Okay, so this is where you decide whether you repeat the 5 step of division or not. So since we are still having a number here, if your divisor can divide into your new number, which is 4, or if you have numbers in the dividend that have not been brought down, then you repeat the 5 step again. What do I mean by that? Now you're seeing that we are having here 4, right? So we are not done. We can't just leave this like that. It's looking very dirty. So we need to what? Repeat the step again until we have what? 0, 0. Okay? So now we are not going to do cocoa because we can't check now. We are not done. So we're going to repeat what? Daddy again. So the same step we did for daddy, okay, we divide 2 into what? Into your new number, and your new number here is what? Is 4, right? This is where we stop. New number is 4. So we place your answer directly above what? 4 in your quotient. So that is to say 2 into 4 will give us what? 2. Okay? So we are done with what, daddy? So let's move with mommy. Mommy said, multiply your divisor, which is this 2. So now I'm not going to be giving you step by step because you guys are expert now. So we are just going to go ahead. So now we are multiplying our divisor, which is 2. Okay, this is our divisor. Follow my cursor. This is my divisor, which is 2. With what? Our new number in what? In the quotient. Okay, so our new number in the quotient is also what? Also 2. So we multiply. Remember, mommy is what? Is multiplication. So we multiply 2 by 2, which gives us what? 4. Now, mommy says, place your answer directly under the 4. So we've written it as this. So 2 times 2, we have it as what? As 4. So mommy is done with her job. So let's go with what? With sister, which is what? Subtraction. So sister says, draw a line under what? Under the bottom of 4. So we've drawn our line, and also she also said we should what? We should write our subtraction sign. We've subtracted, and 4 minus 4 gives us what? 0. Of course, this 0 is also already 0. So we place it under what? Under this line. We've gotten what? Our 0. Okay. Now let's move to what? Brother. Brother said, bring down. Okay. So, but for now, look at your dividend. Let's see our dividend. This is our dividend here. To see if there's any more numbers to bring down. If not, you move to what? Step 5. Now, let's see our dividend. We don't have any numbers, okay? We are done with everything we are doing. So, since there's no any number to bring down, because brother, his job is just to what? Bring numbers down, okay? So, since there's no number for brother to bring down, we move to what? Step 5. And what's our step 5? Our step 5 is what? Can you tell me? It's reminder. It's what? It's repeat. Now, since there is no more number to bring down, and 4 minus 4 is equal to 0, so we have finished with the problem. Meaning that 64 divided by 2 is what? Is 32, which is what? Our quotient. So let's check. Step 6 is what? Is cocoa. We only use cocoa once because we can't just use it continuously, right? We only use it when we are sure that we are done with our division. So cocoa will help us what? To check if our question, if our answer is what? Is correct, okay? So we have here 64 divided by 2, and we have our question to be 32. So what cocoa say? To check your answer with multiplication, you multiply your quotient and divisor. So when you multiply your quotient, which is 32, by your divisor, which is 2, if you get the same answer as your dividend, then give yourself a big clap. Okay, that's what cocoa say. So 32 multiplied by 2 is what? Is 64. And which match is what? With our dividend. Okay, so that is the step we will use in doing long division. Daddy, divide, mommy, multiply, we have sister, subtract, we have brother, bring down, we have rover, which is repeat the step, and we have what? Coco, which is to check if our answer is what? Is correct. And to check if your answer is correct, you multiply the quotient by what your divisor, and if you get the same answer as your dividend, then you are perfectly fine. Okay. So let's see one more problem, and that problem will be we'll have the same whole number, which is 2-digit number, but we'll kind of have with a reminder. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so daddy is happy. Daddy say you did it. Mommy say you are smart. Sister say you are awesome, cool guy, and wolf. All right, so our next question is find the quotient 14 divided by 8. Now, someone will come and tell mommy that, auntie did not taught us quotient, so I've not heard of that quotient. I've not heard of the English before. So now you are knowing what you want to divide. Quotient means you get the answer. So now we have to speak what? Mathematics, okay? So you can't just say find 16 divided by 4. So now find the quotient 14 divided by what? 8. So don't go and tell mommy that I've not taught you what is quotient. So I introduced it in the beginning of this class. Okay, let's see how we'll do that. So the first thing is we have to place what? We have this 14. Okay, I'm first. 14 divided by what? By 8. So let's go. We have here 14 divided by 8. Follow my mouse. So how many times can 8 go into what? 14. It's just 1 times, right? So 1 times 8, we have 8. Okay, so we've done with daddy. Daddy say how many times it will go with the first the number 14, which is 1. 1 times 8, okay, which is multiply mommy, is what is 8. So now our sister is saying what we should subtract. 14 minus what? Minus 8 is what? Is 6. So we have to what? Repeat the step again, right? So now, how many times can 6 go into, can 8 go into what? Into 6. How many times can 8 go into 6? You see, it can't go into 6 because it's smaller than 8, right? So because of that, we have to what? Put a decimal point here. So putting a decimal point here, meaning that we have to now bring down what? Our zeros, right? So now we have bringing down zero, meaning that we have what? 60. And because of 60 here, we brought down zero, we have to what? Put a decimal point after what? After 1. So we say what? 8 into what? 60 is what? How many times? 8 into 60. Remember here we did what? 14 divided by 8, which gives us what? 6. So we are not done because we've not gotten 0. We have to still repeat it again. So 8 into 60, it goes 7 times, but there is still a remainder. Okay, so we just leave the remainder there. So since it's going to 7 times, we'll write 7 at top. So that's for daddy. So mommy says 7 multiplied by what? By 8. 7 multiplied by 8 will give us what? Will give us 56. Okay, see my cursor here. 56. So next thing sister says what? We should subtract. And 60 minus 56 would give us what? Give us 4. Okay. So now brother say what? Bring down. So we are bringing down what? The next zero. You see? Now we kind of was repeating like what? Like 3 times, right? You know the other one we repeat just 2 times. So now we are repeating what? 3 times because we still have more numbers at the dividend. So now we are bringing down zero. So we're going to start with daddy again because we cannot just check because we are not done, right? So 8 into what? 40 is how many times? We give us 5 times. So that's for daddy. And mommy says 5 times what? 8 gives us what? 40. Okay, so sister will now subtract, which gives us what? 0. Brother, which is bring down, will not check if there's any number to bring down. There's no number to what? To bring down. So we are done. Our answer is what? 1.75. So 14 divided by 8, the quotient which we are asked to look for is what? 1.75. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the class. Just a quick recap of what we've achieved today. We've divided whole numbers, 2-digit number. We limit ourselves in this class. Obviously, now next class we're going to be looking at like 3-digit number for remainder, and with the one with that was remainder. And we're going to what? Follow the step. So we make use of what? Members of our family to memorize what? Long division. Our daddy is divide, which is the first step. The second step is our mommy, which is what? Multiplication. The third step is what? Is sister, which is what? Subtraction. The first step is what? Is a brother. Brother's job is just to bring down. You know, brothers are just, they can't just do something very, very so serious. So their job is just to what? Bring down. Okay, that's just their job. So the next step, which is the fifth step, is what? Is rover. That means to repeat the step again. Okay, the rover, just repeat the step. If there's any number next to what? To your dividend. Okay, you repeat the step. But if there's not, then you go to the sixth step, which is what? Coco. And Coco will help you to what? To check. So what I want you to do, you check if our answer is correct. So what you to check is what? You multiply your quotient by what? By your divisor, and you get what? We get 14. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the class. Please go through this video 2 or 3 times for better understanding. And if you have any question, don't forget to drop it in our Google Classroom. I must commend you guys. You guys are really doing well. Your assignment, you guys are very perfect. Just give yourself a big clap. So you're going to see this slide in your Google Classroom, and you're going to also have your assignment. All right. So stay safe and bye for now.